I'm afraid if I say the word naked, I will be demonetized. I'm sure it's appealing to someone. I'm sure. I'm sure someone is jumping for joy. I should stay on topic, right? Yeah, I'm not going to. When do I ever? Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44. No. I'm 45 from the Netherlands. Hence the accent. And today is another Let's Talk Makeup New Makeup Releases. I have a lot. Yeah, last week there was no episode because it was my birthday and another video went online. So I have quite a lot to get to. And yeah, let's hope that I can keep it a little bit short and stay on topic. Wish me luck though. Let's start with what I have on the eyeballs. On my eyeballs, I have a hairless kitty cat. Yes, because I'm afraid that if I say the word naked, I will be demonetized, but I'm not sure. Basically, it is this one, the latest six-pen palette from Sigil Inspired that I got in the mail today. Here she is. And this shade, it's so deceptive because when I look at it, it is a minty blue. And when it is on my eye, it is more along the lines of a green. So it is very, very exciting. It's a pretty light palette. But yeah, I'm filming two looks with it. This is the first one. And then another one will be in that video as well. And I don't know when it will be online. Probably next week. But if you want to see the other look or how I created this look, make sure that you have hit the subscribe button and then the bell button. So you will be notified when it goes online. Yeah, I have a lot of new stuff in, actually. I'm looking in my new stuff basket. A lot of exciting stuff is coming, so just make sure that you have hit the subscribe button and the bell button, as I have already said. Yes, this video series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist and the community playlist are both in the description box, as are my sources and the brands that I will mention today. And yeah, basically the products as well. I don't know if I will have room to list my makeup, but you know the eyeshadow palette. The falsies are from AOA Studio 3D Foam Ink in the style Nora, which are, as you can see, probably open and spiky. And the lippy is just a lip balm from Catrice, a 5-in-1 lip balm in the shade Lychee Glaze, which I thought would kind of complement the eye look. And then that is kind of the most important thing now, isn't it? So yeah, that's it. Let me open up Instagram and go to the side. Saved folder. I had so much saved because I had stuff saved from 2 weeks that I actually removed some things as well that I was like, yeah, you know what, I don't really find it that interesting to talk about because I have a lot. I have that luxury, basically. So yeah, I have quite a few things here. Some things that are fun, some things I'm like, yes. Let's just get into it. Let's start with a few updates. Let's start with that because I have here an update from BH Cosmetics. Not last week, but 2 weeks ago in the last episode, I mentioned that BH Cosmetics was collaborating with Alondra, Essie and Elsie Guevara. I still don't really know who they are. I do know they are BFFs and they have launched the BFF collection with BH Cosmetics. And I just wanted to show you the palette. And what else do we have? We have a palette, we have a face... we have an eye palette, we have a face palette, and we have lippies. The eyeshadow, yeah, it kind of looks fun. But also, yeah, kind of not. I don't know. It could be the picture, because the picture that I'm looking at is the picture that you are seeing in the eyeshadow palette is quite, well, I won't say bright, but more vibrant looking almost. I also saw pictures that it was a little bit more muted. But while I think it is a fun color story for a lot of people, it is not specifically for me. So this is not interesting to me at all. So yeah, but I did want to show you the inside of the palette and your take on it. So let me know what you feel down below in the description box. Are you excited for any of this? If it is the same formula as they are basically doing now, you know what, not gonna lie, I have actually liked BH Cosmetics for quite some time. The first thing that I tried from BH Cosmetics was their Zodiac palette. I really like the formula in that Zodiac palette. So yeah, for me to say they are killing it now, Yeah, but I thought that their formula was very good to begin with, at least what I tried. So yeah, well, this is not for me. Maybe this is bombdiggity.com for you. Let me know down below. Let's next go to the update from Menagerie Cosmetics, because this is the inside of the Flight Club palette that I also mentioned. It is launching February the 26th at 12 p.m. PST. It contains two metallics, two chameleon metallics, and one chameleon satin in a new formula, as well as seven beautiful mattes inspired by the adorable fruit plundering flying fox. Or fruit bat, retails for $38.95 and is estimated to ship early March. I do know though that she is opening up the international shipping again. Let's talk about the inside of the color story. Not gonna lie, I was kind of disappointed a tiny bit. Why? Because when I looked at the outside, I was like, ooh, it's going to be purple and a little bit pink, and then a green in there, and maybe an orange and a yellow. And then looking at the inside, it is basically purple with, I don't know, is it a very pale yellow? At least the picture that I'm looking at looks like a very pale, very, very pale yellow. And then maybe a very pale peachy orangey shade. I would have loved to see a green in here. Why? Because I love green and purple together. So yeah, I do like the color story. But I'm also kind of sad that yeah, it doesn't reflect the outside a little bit more. So I actually think that there could have been a nice yellow and a nice green and even a nice orange to yeah, complement the bat a little bit more, you know, the colors of the bat. But I still think it is very, very cutesy. Am I going to pick it up? Maybe not initially. Why? Well, because it's almost $39 and I love the outside of the palette. The artwork, I love the artwork. I like the inside of the color story as well. I love purple shadows, don't get me wrong, but it is a little bit more expensive and I have quite some things coming in. So I'm a little bit torn. On the one hand, I really want the palette, and on the other hand, I'm like, yeah. But it's a little bit expensive. And the color story is nice, but not what you were hoping to see. So do you really need it? No, I don't need anything, but I still kind of want it though. So it is, let's just say it's a maybe. I'm not completely sure yet, but I do really, really like it. And it is, as I'm filming this, I have 10 days because I'm filming this on Tuesday. So if there are any releases between now that I'm filming this and Friday when the video goes online, yeah, I haven't, well, I probably have seen it when you are seeing this, but I haven't seen it today as I'm filming this on Tuesday. Yes, because I'm pre-filming. If there was an orange and a green in here, I would have been all over this palette in a heartbeat. As it stands now, it is going on the list, but I don't know if I will pick it up instantaneously on release. Does that make any sense at all? So yeah, let me know your thoughts down below. I'm very interested though in the chameleon metallics. Yeah. Let me know your thoughts down below. And the next thing that I have is also from Menagerie Cosmetics. This is, you see the plate, and it is the artwork of the blush palette that she released. It says here, something new we've been working on coming to the store. Collectible trinket dishes with display stand. We wanted something sturdy and beautiful to put our beloved artwork on, and these neat little dishes came to mind. Not sure if these will be limited runs or if we will keep restocking them as long as there's demand. What's your favorite artwork from our brand? Would you display one of these on your vanity dresser or bathroom countertop? Oh, hell yes. Definitely, definitely. This would be. Yeah, I love this. I love this. Why do I love this? Because their artwork is just so stunning. And yeah, I truly. I am, yeah. Not gonna lie, this I could see me getting this for friends as well, you know, because this is something that I have friends who would appreciate this artwork so much, but who are not into makeup. And I would love to have a plate of the Feral. I would love that. Truly. I would also love one from the fruit. I would love them all. Not gonna lie. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this is very much, yeah, it would fit very, very nicely. Oh yeah, I can see myself getting some of these for sure. Yeah, let me know your thoughts. Why am I itchy? Because I probably have cat hair everywhere. Yeah, I would love this. Truly, let me know your thoughts down below. Let's next go to a Madage Beauty London, because they are kind of doing stuff. They are launching their own line. They are launching, and I've mentioned them before, they are launching makeup. They are also launching skincare, which I will touch on first, I think. Shall I do that first? Yeah. So, I mentioned them in the last episode that they were launching makeup and they are also launching skincare. Here you see a picture of the skincare. It looks very, very sleek. And it says here, want glowing winter skin. The range is called Madagestic, I think. Skincare range. It is on their site now. You get an ultimate anti-aging serum for £52. Anti-aging day cream for 40. Anti-aging night cream for 40, anti-aging eye cream for 31. You get an ultra hydrating moisturizing fluid for 28, and then hand and body moisturizer for 16. They also have two bundles. They have the ultimate day and night bundle for £68, but the value is £80, and then the ultimate collection bundle retails for 150, and the value is 191. It is online. Now, I do have a code with them. It will be listed down in the description box. As I said last time, there is stuff on its way to me because I'm also on the PR list, but I don't really know what is on its way to me as of yet. So I have no idea if there is just makeup or if there's also skincare included in the PR package. I don't know. It does look very, very nice though. Not gonna lie. Yeah, it looks very sleek. It looks very high end. The prices are a little bit more expensive. I don't know the ingredients that are in here though, so I cannot give my opinion on them. Let me know if you are interested. I am, because but yeah, I'm interested in what they are doing. They are a new and up and coming brand, but they are also kind of a reseller. Because what they have also done is this. You see here Catkin and ZC, because they are stocking those two brands as well. These are Chinese brands. The brands are cruelty-free and vegan, and they can be if they are made in China. If they are made in China, they are not subject to animal testing per se. So a Chinese brand can be cruelty-free. And obviously vegan. ZC, I have seen and I have talked about them a few times because their whole aesthetic, their artwork, it's so pretty. Catkin Cosmetics, I wasn't familiar with, but once I saw it, and I will put a picture up, I will just grab a picture. What am I going to grab? I don't know what I'm going to grab. I will see. But the artwork that I see here, it's also very, very pretty. So yeah, that's what is going to be stocked as well. So if you are having your eye on, for instance, ZC, they have a USA site as well. You can also find some things on AliExpress because they also have an official store there. But now they are also available in Europe through the UK. So maybe that is something interesting for you to check out. I am guessing my code works on their entire site. I'm guessing. I think so. You could try. That's basically it. I'm kind of excited about this. So yeah, I think it's very exciting to see what they are doing because they're at first I thought they were just a new makeup brand, but they're not only just a new makeup brand, they're also a makeup site that kind of is going to go for the more maybe a little bit higher end and something that is not something new instead of the mainstream brands. Maybe that's a better description. Let me know your thoughts down below. I am quite excited to see what they are doing. Yeah. The next brand is a brand that I was tagged in. I did not know them before I got tagged in this. This is a brand from Arizona. They are cruelty-free and vegan, and they are called Kalani. Am I saying that correctly? Yeah, Kalani by Leilani, I think. And they have a bunch of stuff. So you see here a picture of a very big bright palette with mattes, shimmers, and pressed glitters. It's not specifically for me, but I did want to mention it because from my understanding, this is a very, well, I saw it's a very tiny brand, but yeah, I thought that they deserved some loving. And they have a bunch of stuff. So they have bigger palettes, as you see here, the picture of. They also have falsies, they have lippies, they have concealers, they have a bunch of stuff, guys. So they also have a smaller palette, very, very small. And PayPal and pickup available. And I will, yeah, I will leave the site down below. Let me know if you know the brand, if you have ever ordered from the brand. I like small brands. Well, I like big brands too. But I like it when you guys send me stuff in DM or through DM on Instagram. And I also love it when you tag me because I just love finding new brands. So yeah, let's go to the eyeshadow palette. I like the colors in here. I do think it's too big. That's what she said. Yeah, for me, I'm not a very big palette person. Too many options. That's basically it. I do like the color story. Could it have been curated down? Yeah, probably. Yeah, not gonna lie. I can see some shades, some of the orange shades, some of the yellow ones, some of the purple ones that if you use them and you blend them out, they will probably pull very, very similar. But I do think that the color story is fun. It's not for me, but I did want to mention it to you. Let me know your thoughts down below. Let's next go to Glamonatrix Cosmetics because this is the latest palette. It's the You Beauty palette, I believe. You get duochromes, mattes, foils, multi-chrome, duochrome. So basically mattes, duochromes and multi-chromes and shimmery goodness. Yeah, I like the color story. Glamonatrix is Queensland, that's Australia, right? Yeah, I think so. I like this color story, guys. It is something different. Australia is going into autumn now, right? Well, yeah, kind of. We are going towards, well, we are still kind of in winter. We are going towards spring. So they are still in summer going towards autumn. Yeah, I like this color story. And it makes sense for their time of year as well. I like it. I've never tried Glamonatrix, but I have heard some very, very nice things about them. I like this color story. So yeah, let me know down below your thoughts. Yeah, again, I like the color story. I like it. Oh yeah, let me put up this picture. Do I need to say anything? When I saw this, I was like, oh, that's a Colourpop palette. Did I miss a Colourpop palette? But no, it's Morphe. It's the Morphe 9E Pretty in Peach. I'm sure it's appealing to someone. I'm sure. I'm sure someone is jumping for joy. It's not me though. I love orange eyeshadow. I love peach eyeshadow, but yeah. Let's go to Artist Couture. This is the Welcome to Ethereal Bloom palette. It says, flourish this spring season with an array of dreamy pastels and glittering hues. Collection revealed. It will release the 19th of February, 12 p.m. PST on artistcouture.com and sephora.com. So it's a palette and it is a loose thingy. A diamond lights finisher. That's what a loose thingy is called. So, yeah, I like the color story. When I see the palette and the picture that I have here, it's a little bit that I'm like, ¿qué? What? But when I look at the swatches, I'm like, yeah, I like it. You know what I like about this? The fact, and I have said this before, but looking at the swatches, you have a matte and then a corresponding shimmer. And I love that. I don't know. Pastels just suck me in. Do they look good on me? Not always. But they still suck me in anyway. Because I do like the color story. I like this color story as well. A lot actually. I don't know what it retails for. I don't know if artist couture is expensive or if it is basically normal. I don't know, but I do really like the color story. Let me know your thoughts down below. I'm curious to know. Okay, let's next go to Spoiled Lips Cosmetics, because this is the Gamer Girl palette. There is only one purchase date, and that's March the 15th. That's what it says here. So I don't... I think then that is basically the date, March 15th, and when it is sold out, it's not coming back. I think that's it. Or maybe if they have stock left on the 16th, you cannot buy it anymore. I don't exactly know, but I did want to mention it because I thought it was fun. I don't, when I see the outside, I think it's fun. Is it a bitch to store? Yeah, so am I though. Because I don't fit in any cupboard or box. I like the color story. I have heard from different people that the formula with the lips embossing on it is the best. Now I have here lips and hearts, so I don't know how this formula is. I think this is for someone who is a true gamer, who also loves makeup. I don't want to say true gamer, because it does not really matter if you're a true gamer. There is no true gamer. You're a gamer or you're not a gamer, right? So, someone who really likes to play games and doesn't mind that the packaging looks like a controller either. Is it for me? No, it's not necessarily. No, it's not. It's not. I like the idea of this a lot. I love the color story, but it is not for me. But maybe it is for you. Let me know if you are excited. I don't know anything else besides the date is the 15th of March. I don't know time. I don't know price. I don't know anything else, but I will leave the site down below. Let me know your thoughts down below. Let's next go to Forever Purple Cosmetics, because this is the Life of the Mardi eyeshadow palette. It's Mardi Gras inspired. I would love to go to Mardi Gras one day. But yeah. Yeah, what can I say? What is happening? I have weird bits on the screen and I don't know why, but it is recording, so it's apparently all good. I don't know. But yeah, I was talking about makeup. Yeah, Mardi Gras. I don't know. It kind of has a pull for me. I've never been, but it has a pull for me. I love the color story. I love dark purples and yellows. I love dark purples and orange and green and even bright blue. I love that. I love this color story. Do I know anything else? Let's see. Forever Purple Cosmetics is... It says here, it's a cosmetic company created for the lovers of the color purple, makeup and being free. I think that's fun. I don't know prices, I think, though. Maybe I can see here. I have here a code. Code is Mardi. I don't know if it is valid when you are seeing this. I will leave the site down below because I'm guessing it is online. But I don't know. Yeah, it's available, but I don't know prices. And I don't feel like going to the website to find out. So yeah, there's that. But I do really like the color story. I like it. It makes me happy to look at. Yeah, let me know your thoughts. Oh, never mind. I was lying. I can see what it's costing here. $20. I should learn to scroll. So it's $20 and it's available now. I like it a lot. Let me know your thoughts down below. Let's go next to another brand I had never heard of before. I have a lot of brands that are new to me in this episode, which I really do like. Let's go to Baby K Cosmetics. And this is the Bad Girl eyeshadow palette. It features 12 colors, 8 mattes, 4 shimmers. And it retails for $28. It will launch the 19th at 11. 11 is the Dutch word for 11. It was also a show back in the day. You know, the alien who ate cats? Never mind. 11 a.m. PST, that's when it launches, on the 19th. I like this color story. What you see on the outside, color-wise, is what you get on the inside. I really like that. I really, really do. I like the fact that you can go a little bit more muted. maybe a little bit more every day. I like the fact that there are basically safer pinks in here, you know, again, the little more muted ones, but that you can also brighten it up and spruce it up. I like the fact that there's a yellow and a green in there. I like it. Yes, a lot. Let me know down below if you know the brand. Let me know if you are excited. I like it. So yeah. I like liking things. Yes. Never mind. Let's go next to Ofra and their collaboration with Steph Toms. And I know that Steph is, she is a UK, is she a makeup artist? I think she is. But this is the Milk and Cookies highlighter, right? Yeah. Milk is a seriously intense icy cream shade, and Cookies is a softer but still popping rose gold bronze. Ooh, that would look pretty on me. Swirled together, they are a match made in heaven. Oh, and it smells of cookie dough too. Milk and Cookies will be on sale from the 22nd of February at ofracosmetics.com. And yes, it is going to be on Beauty Bay as well. So I am guessing from this post that it will launch simultaneously on Ofra's site and on Beauty Bay, which I have never seen Ofra do, which makes sense because she's from the UK. Yeah, it's very pretty. I have the Samantha March collab. Steph is deeper color-wise, so more my... Maybe she's even darker than me, but I'm actually not sure. Maybe we're kind of... When I look at this picture, I'm like, she's way more darker than me. She's way more tan. But I don't know. I do know, though, that I am glad that I didn't get Samantha March's curated highlighter. Because Pillow Talk and... Is it Rodeo Drive that she had in there? Basically, the pinky and the yellow, they're too light for me. Unfortunately. So, yeah, I got the All of the Lights highlighter. And there... I have more shades to choose from. This though, I think I could make show up on me without it giving me a light cast, you know? And then that bronzy, yeah, it sounds pretty. Truly, it sounds very, very pretty. So yeah, congrats Steph on your collab with Ofra. I think it's amazing. I think Ofra has a very, very nice highlighter formula. I like this. I actually think it will come to the Netherlands as well, because Samantha March's collab came to Boozy Shop as well. But you can still order from a Beauty Bay without having to worry about import tax if you live in the Netherlands. That is because the import tax price is included in the Beauty Bay price that you pay. So you're not getting hit when it comes to your door. I know, because I've done it twice since Brexit. I wanted to say breakfast, but it's Brexit. Never mind. I think this looks very, very pretty. Yeah, very pretty. Let me know your thoughts down below. Let's go next to... Oh yeah, the crayon case. I know there has been drama with the crayon case in the past, but I thought this was very, very cutesy, and that is why I'm mentioning it. This is... these are new eyeshadow palettes. They are coming soon. They are so cool. These are notepad palettes, but how freaking cool! I really, really like this. I like the color stories too. I truly like these guys. Truly. I don't know anything else. But I do like these. Let me know your thoughts. Oh, Lord. Not gonna lie. I like these a lot. Yeah. Okay. Let's next go to... I already mentioned this one. So you can go away. Yes, you can go away. Oh, yes. Let's go to something that I have on its way to me. I hope at least. I ordered it. Let's just say that. Why? Because I'm a sucker for packaging. And I love bees. And bumblebees especially. So, yeah. In last week's episode of Friday, I mentioned the fact that I was supposed to be at the tattoo artist. Because I'm getting a bumblebee tattoo for here. I don't know when I will get it, though. First, we need to be out of lockdown. But there's a bumblebee tattoo. I'm getting one. Yes, I've wanted one for years. I love bumblebees. Yes, with a passion. And then when I saw that Guilty Cosmetics from the Brow Jam, I did a video. It is online. I will link it if I don't forget. Yeah, underneath the card. She released this, the bumblebee Brow jam. Smells like golden honey with a hint of vanilla. When I saw it, I was like, God damn it, I need it. So I ordered it. I know I have a full jar, but it's a bumblebee and it also saves the bees, so leave me alone. It says here, it's time to save the bees. Once a month, we will be donating profits from sales of the bumblebee brow jam. So everyone go buy the bumblebee brow jam to different charities to help save the bees. Why do we need to save the honeybee? Well, basically, if we don't have honeybees, we don't have food. That is the gist of it, people. It's not that deep. But yeah, I love bees. I should stay on topic, right? Yeah, I'm not going to. When do I ever? So yeah, I love bees. Especially bumblebees. Yes, when I was little, I used to save bumblebees from my inflatable kiddie pool that was in the garden. So yeah, that was it. And then when they didn't survive, they needed to be buried. They needed to have a name. They needed to have their own casket and a little wooden cross. I was that child. Yes. So yeah, never mind. I never said I was normal, right? But yeah, I love, truly, truly love. I love bees, but bumblebees especially. Yeah, they are so fluffy. Oh, they're so cute. Never mind. Let's go. Go buy the brow jam, the bumblebee brow jam, and save the bees. They're based in the UK. The brow jam retails for £10. Go get it. Even if you don't, you just do. And then tell them that I sent you. So yeah, let's never mind. Let's next go to Eclectic Beauty Cosmetics. Because this is the new collection. It is called the Hotel Antoinette. It's live at eclecticbeautycosmetics.com. You get 3 matte liquid lipsticks retailing for $15 each. The colors are navy, gold and cherry wood. Okay, that's very interesting actually. And then you get 6 Phantom Haze translucent powders. They retail for $25 each. You get Heliotrope is a colorless one. Then you also get a light beige, a banana, medium peach, neutral brown or rich brown. And then there are also 5 blushes, $20 each. You get a light pink, an earthy orange, orange peach, raspberry pink and reddish blush. And that's it. Yeah, it looks pretty. I like the aesthetic of this a lot. It gives me wintry vibes without it being overly wintry. I like it. I don't know the brand, but I do really like it. Let me know if you know the brand. Let me know if you have tried any of their stuff. If you are excited about this, let me know. Because I am very, very curious. You see here a picture. This is from Mora. No, it's actually from the Beauty Independent. That's where the post is from on Instagram. But it's from the brand Mora Cosmetics. They are halal. Halal? I would say halal in Dutch. Halal. Halal just doesn't sound right. So I'm going to go with halal. It's a halal makeup brand. It launched in December with 3 chic, clean and vegan lipsticks priced at $25 each. I have never, did I? I don't think I have ever heard a brand being halal before. A makeup brand, that is. So that is why I wanted to mention it. And I like the way that this looks. I like the colors. I never heard of the brand. And I thought, this is something funky. Let me mention it. That's it, basically. Do we have anything else? I don't think so. I think that's it. Oh, wait, what's this? No. That's, I need to go to Mora. Ah, here, Mora Cosmetics. Yeah, halal, clean, vegan, California. That's where they are. And they have lipsticks. I love it. I'm going to leave the site down below. Let me know if you know the brand. Because I'm actually very, very curious. Let me follow them. Because why not? Okay. Okay, okay. Let's next go to Shaki Cosmetics, I think. They're based in America. And they have launched a feminine collection. That's what it's called, I think. Yeah, it's the feminist eyeshadow palette. It's an 18 pen palette. Let's see. 6 mattes and 12 pressed pigment shimmers. Yes, so shimmers, not glitters. Okay. It's 100% vegan. It's cruelty free. The price is $43. Oh no, a kitty cat is entering the room. It says here... Oh no, it's that kitty cat. That's not what it says. That's what I... Never mind. Hello, kid. Hello, child. Yes, you are the backbone of my channel. Oh, apparently it's raining because I have a wet kitty cat here. I'm not going to say it because I will probably get demonetized, but you get the gist. Okay, let's... do you know this brand? Do you know the brand? Have you tried them? The palette looks pretty. The colors look pretty as well. I don't know if it is worth $43. I cannot say because I haven't tried it. But yeah, it looks pretty. Let me know your thoughts down below. Oh yeah, let's next go to this. This is from... I can be very quick about it. This is something that I would want for the packaging. This is from Nabla. This is their new mascara. It's called Vicious. It's available already. And I kind of want it because it's a Black Panther / Kitty Cat. If I were to buy this, it would be purely for the packaging, truly, truly, because I have a mascara that I love. It's a tube mascara. I don't know what kind of mascara this is, but when I saw it, I was like, I need it. I haven't ordered it though, so yay me. But yeah. Do you really need to headbutt the microphone? Apparently he does. Can you go lie down, please? You're making me nervous. So yeah, I want that mascara, but... for the packaging only. Yes, I'm like that. Yes, I am. Let's next go to this from Lurella Cosmetics. It is... No, stop it. It is their Daydreamer eyeshadow palette. It's 10 shades, 5 shimmers, 5 mattes. And it is pastels. It retails for $13. I don't know the quality, but I really like the look of this. Yeah, not gonna lie. What are you doing? I think when I look at the swatches, they are very, very pastel-y. I don't think that they will work on a deeper skin tone at all. Looking at the swatches, I think they look pretty ashy. But I like the way that this is looking, people. Yes. What can I say? I like the way this is looking a lot. That's it. Yes, that's it. Let's go. Yeah, can you just please lie down? Oh Lord. Let's go next to Pout and Shout. And I feel like I'm mentioning them almost every week. But that's okay because I really like the brand. This is she made 2 mini highlighters / eyeshadow singles to add to the Feral collection. I don't know if they are available anymore though, because the post was from a week ago. But yeah, I still wanted to mention them. The shade Thistle is a metallic dirty green with silver notes, and then the other one is called Weathered, and it's a coppery bronze. Yeah, I like the shade Thistle a lot. They are handmade, vegan, and crafted from upcycled packaging. I don't know if they are still available. I truly do not. However, I will leave her Instagram handle down below, because you order through DM. And I just go follow her. And then the next thing that I have here is the Patchwork Heart. It's one of a kind Valentine's Day eyeshadow palette with a twist. So I'm guessing it's... Yes, we needed to pause for kisses. Okay. I'm guessing it's already sold out, but still, I really want to... I'm just going to keep on mentioning her because she's just doing such a cool job. She's so freakishly creative. She just needs to be blowing up and having her own factory, truly. It's just, she has done, oh, she's done more. Of course she has, because she's also, I also see here lippies and such. Why did I miss that? Because apparently I missed that. Go follow her on Instagram, please, because it's just, yeah. She also has a Blogspot. I will link that, and I will leave her Instagram handle down below as well. Yes, that was it? Okay. So you're welcome. He graced you with his presence. And cat hair. Yes. Let's next go to Melt, because they have minis. I love it. I truly do. They have a nude lippy bundle, and they have a red lippy bundle, and they have a Melt mini stack. And I think it's very, very cutesy. That's it. Very, very cutesy. I was looking at the nude lippies. There are some very, very nice colors there. But yeah, if I would... I would wait for me personally. I would wait until it comes here to Europe. Beauty Bay or something like that. Yeah, I like it. What can I say? I'm a sucker for small things. That's it. Let me know if you are excited. Okay, let's next go to this. And I'm kind of bummed because I missed out. This is the latest palette from Sigil Inspired, Tammy Tanuka. And it is called the Wind Rose Eyeshadow Palettes. Because it's the same thing as her Flaming Gold. Basically, I've mentioned this before, but her six pans are called eggs. These are called books. There's a whole story behind them. And basically, you have a big palette containing all the shades. Then you have a micro palette containing all the shades. And I have the micro Flaming Gold. And then she also has the color story split apart into five pan palettes. And you can just pick up whatever you like. Unfortunately, she releases on Sunday 12. Is that then 12 a.m. or p.m.? It's not midnight, but it's in the afternoon. Yeah, that one. And then Russian time. So I think that she also restocks around that time. So if you're eyeing anything, check out Sunday and then 12 p.m. in the afternoon, Moscow time. If you Google that, then you can see what it is in your time zone. But by the time I thought, oh yeah, it's Sunday, she's releasing a new palette, it was already sold out. So I know it's going to restock. And when it does, I will pick it up. Yeah, not gonna lie. I love the color story in here. I think it is so, so pretty. I know that it's going to restock, but I don't know exactly when. Maybe I can see real quick. See real quick. See translation. The restock is scheduled for next month. So that's March, because this was from 1 week ago. So yeah, I will just keep on checking, because yeah, I want it. It is really up my alley. I love the color story as well. I think the color story is gorgeous. I'm going for the micro palette again, because I kind of have decided that the eggs, the six pans, I want in the bigger size, and these I want in a micro size, because I just like it that way. Yeah, that's it. The duochromes, that shade 57, which was Northern Lights, I believe. Oh, green to purple. Oh. So yeah, so when it restocks, it will be mine one day. Let's just say that, but it is sold out currently. Okay, let's next go to Makeup Maniacs, because this is the Green Goddess 3 palette. It's a new makeup release. It is available already. It retails for $24, 16 shades. There's also a multi-chrome glitter and a new multi-chrome pressed glitter. Yeah, I'm so sad about that though, because I really do like the color story, but I don't want those glitters. If I can help it. I think that's, yeah. If there would have been shimmers, I probably would have ordered the palette. I do know, though, that my friend Liora has an affiliate code with them. And it is Liora10. I will leave it down in the description box. So, yeah, that's basically it. Yeah, it looks pretty. But unfortunately, press glitters, yeah, if I can help it. I know that according to Liora, at least, that the formula is amazing. And I know what she likes. And we are kind of on the same page of what we like eyeshadow-wise. So I'll probably love the formula as well. It's just that, yeah, the press glitters, it's not so much my thing. Next, let me know your thoughts down below. Have you ever tried Makeup Maniacs? Let me know down in the description box. So yeah, that was it. I'm still here at the site to give a special shout out to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to the merch shop where you can find the hoodie that I am wearing, which says Glip Gloss. I also have Nestling hoodie vests, and I also have a Glip Gloss with red lettering. Go check it out if you like to. As I said, the link is down in the description box. And then that was it for today. Yes, a longer episode again, but yeah, that's what you get when you kind of skip a week. Let me know what you thought of the finds I had this week. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. Mine does. Today. Which is very, very good. And I will see you, well, I see you tomorrow. Could very well be that I will see you tomorrow for another video. And otherwise, it's going to be next week. So yeah, have an amazing weekend, guys. See you soon. Bye.